here, okay?
Good afternoon.
Well, that sounds more like it. So, for those of you that don't know, I am Chaplain Jerry Riggert. I am the former chaplain here who retired. Got to know both Fred and Audrey before my retirement, and then as I would come back to help off and on, would get to see them both from time to time, especially Audrey here in the chapel, and then in other connections to visit and share time and share words of faith and hope together. I'm back on a short term. I am the chaplain right now, even though it's part time. So I got to see Audrey after she got back from the hospital, and I will share a thought that comes from one of the other pastors of Trinity Lutheran Church. I was on a mission to find her because we didn't have the word that she got to the hospital. And when she did get back from the hospital, I did get her tracked down, and I did get Pastor McCauley notified that she was back and where she was at. And Pastor McCauley is one that he made the comments. I said, "Is there anything you want me to share?" And he said, "Well, Audrey told him because she was always going back and forth, doing whatever the activity was, social hour, whatever. She was out and about, and was not always easy to find. And Pastor McCauley would always try and track her down." And her comment to him one day was, "You know, the Lutherans have done a better job of tracking me down than the Baptists ever did." Just Audrey's wit, you know, and she just laid it out there. She had never seen me other than clean shaven. And this beard started after the Lord called her home. And if she were here today, she would probably look at me and knowing that Fred always had a beard, would probably have made some comment about me and my razor being broken or something, you know, of that nature. But we're here because the Lord has called Audrey into his nearer presence. We're here gathered for a service of remembrance and celebration of the life of Audrey Fierst. And as we gather, we're doing so. Audrey would say, "Don't shed the tears," but she would say, "Have a time of joy." The time of joy is, we're gonna have the opportunity for some family remembrances of what we share today and community friends. But we're also gonna look at that wonderful gift of faith that the Lord Jesus gave her. We're gonna remember that and know that she is now safely in the arms of Jesus, and she has joined her beloved Fred. And I'll just say that the closing song, when we get there, is most appropriate. You just have to wait and listen when it comes up. So we've had the beautiful hymns that have been prepared, the gospel hymns that have been shared, "Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine." Audrey knew that the Lord Jesus was her Savior and that he had made her his own. And so we turn to the opening verses in our oral service. "We're gathered in Christ's name to celebrate the life of Audrey Fierst. Let us praise God, who is our certain hope in all life circumstances. In the face of death, we believe the good news which the Scriptures proclaim. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son,
that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life."
Let us hear again the good news of the resurrection faith that comforts our hearts and lifts our spirits. We remember the promise of our Lord Jesus Christ, who said,
"I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die."
We hear a beautiful hymn, "Amazing Grace."
Amen. bosom bright shining as the
say.
Amen.
Well, again, we can do better than that. And all God's people say,
Amen.
I invite you to join with me as we have printed the King James Version of the 23rd Psalm, a favorite of Audrey's, and one that we take to heart as we read this psalm together. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil.
My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life,
and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
We hear the beautiful hymn in the garden.
Garden alone, while the dew still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. The joy we share. speaks, and the sound of his voice is so sweet that the birds hush their singing, and the melody that he gave to me within ever.